Last day was filled with slaps. I guess gotta run this shit back. Didn't like the way this shit went down. After awards, I admitted it turned to a beast. This that shit right here that get me going. After I pop me a piece, where do we killing the critics and killing the hate? Might gotta talk to a priest.
Hey, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna go through another boxing training session. Today I'm gonna be wearing my brand new 16-ounce Nemea boxing gloves. These are not for sale, so there's no link in the fucking bio. You're gonna have to wait, but I'm gonna try them out today and see how they go. Coach is gonna put us through some drills, so let's get warmed up. I'm gonna knock out 12 minutes of jump rope and 4 rounds of shadow boxing, and by that time we'll get into the boxing drills. Let's get into it.
Wrap up, get into some shadow boxing. Goal is to stay relaxed, go through your techniques. I'm not trying to throw a million punches throughout the rounds. I'm gonna try to work on my technique, work on my form, sit down on my punches, turn over all of my shots, keep my elbows in, fundamental basic things. You know, shadow boxing is one of the most important ways, things in boxing, training methods in boxing, because you're practicing your moves, you know, choreographing, you're practicing over and over again. You're kind of getting it so it's muscle memory. You don't want to get into the ring and think about how to throw a punch. You know, it should be automatic. You don't want to be thinking, how do I throw a shot? How does this punch gonna look if I try to do it? You know, in the fight, you want to see an opening and you want to take it. That's why it's so important. Just like, you know, like a ballerina practicing, you know, ballet. You gotta choreograph the moves.
Last couple videos, we did some the footwork steps, approaching an opponent, moving away from an opponent. The next level of that is angling. And angling can be as simple as, I don't necessarily always want to attack Ryan straight through his offense. Like, that's not necessarily the smartest way to go in, okay? So I got little movements over this way, that way. I'm taking angles. I'm not letting him set his feet, one thing. And then maybe I zig and he zags, and now I got that little opening. So it's just like a little chess match at first, just to try to get them to move one way, then I slip the other way. Now I got that line into attack where I'm not attacking them through their punches. It just gives me a little advantage. And then sometimes a little advantage is all you need. The first angle we're gonna do will be just off the basic footwork. Think, move sideways, move sideways, move sideways, throw some punches. So we'll just work that on the bag for a minute. I got two directions to go. It depends on what my strong points are, what my opponent's given to me, or are they a southpaw or orthodox fighter? And the more difficult part is whether they're moving forwards, they're stationary, or they're backing up. If they're backing up, it's really, really hard to take an angle. You're not gonna get an advantageous position. You might as well just keep backing them up and go to work. If they're coming towards you, you can do the bull and the matador, kind of braid them in, and when they commit to their shots, sidestep, turn, either direction, and let your hands go. If they're stationary, I gotta do something first. I gotta freeze them up. I gotta get them stuck on defense. I gotta bait them into something before I take that angle. Otherwise, they're just gonna turn with me. And I like doing these, keeping the basic rules of boxing. There are definitely some guys that can switch stances and do it really well, but there's a time and a place and a way to do that. You don't want to get caught crossing your feet in front of somebody. I don't want to end up squaring up in front of somebody, because I'm gonna be vulnerable, I'm gonna be off balance, and I have the chance to get caught. So now I got two directions to go, but I can set up either hand. Move to the outside, look for a cross, I might look for a hook. You know, I got a lot of options to do, and where my opponent is gives me the opportunity to try different things. So the first one we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the outside, and we're gonna set up a cross. So I'm gonna freeze them up with a 1-2. I'm hoping to get them stuck on the back leg, get their hands up, maybe blind them.
Attention fighters, are you just getting started on your boxing journey and struggling with the fundamentals? Join our community down below, where we've created a course to solve that problem for you. This is a community to share tips, to share knowledge, to connect with other fighters, and to improve your skills and awareness in the sport. We'll see you in there.
I'm gonna lead with my left leg, almost forward, just a little bit to the side, and I'm gonna realign, already ready to throw my cross. And we'll throw a 2-3-2, because it's better to throw a combo than just a single punch. So 1-2 to freeze them, take my angle, 2-3-2. You can do it with a punch, you can do it after your punch, but what we're doing is we're looking for our punches after we get our angle, because it's such an advantageous position to be in. So 1-2, step around to your left, 2-3-2. Nice. on to setting up the hooks. Sometimes the fighters are savvy and Ben sees me trying to get an angle, he might start moving. Just come in with a jab. Or if you accidentally, you put yourself too far away. You didn't necessarily waste it. I want to keep them under the threat of some offense. I want to keep them uncomfortable, and now I'm here, I can go there, okay?
So what do you do if someone does get the angle on you?
Take the angle this way. First thing I'm gonna do is right? I know I'm in a bad position. I'm gonna drop my level and make myself a smaller target, and then try to create as much space as I can. But it depends, like, he takes the angle. I might try to smother him really quick. Or I might try to create space really quick. It's my judgment on the fly to figure out which one is better for me at that moment. We're gonna go to the left, but set up a hook. So I wanna freeze him up with the 1-2-3 again. Trying to get him stuck on defense, maybe blind him a little bit. And I'm always gonna leave with my left leg first. This time I'm gonna swing my back leg around to line myself up. I'm gonna keep my left shoulder open because I know the hook's coming. I'm gonna plant the back foot. And then that hook puts me back into my stance, back in my position. All right. So we'll throw a couple punches off of that. So what's happening, Ben's a little slow to come in. This is from his blind side. This is where he doesn't see the punch coming, right? So if he doesn't have that hand down, he's trying to find me. Boom, he walks right into that hook. That's why sometimes I use the right hand. Bang. Sometimes I use the hook. I mean, it just depends on, I might try two or three, figure out which one works. So 1-2-3, turn the corner, 3-2-3.
1-2-3, step, pivot.
You're showing me too much of the hook there. You're like, right? 1-2-3. I'm just keeping the shoulder open. Yeah. And then I'm gonna plant the back foot and then throw the hook. Yeah, there you go. Sacrifice power for a little speed, or I might sacrifice a little speed for a little power. You know, there's more than one way to do it, but I like this way because I make sure I'm in my stance, I'm sturdy, I'm in the right position. 1-2-3, sneaky step.
Oh, with the front foot, yes.
Yeah, and I'm just bringing the back foot in line. And as soon as I plant, turn. So that one would be if I'm setting up my position to set up a little more power shots. In the same direction, there's also like the check hook one, where I'm half turning them and half turning myself. I throw something, I see him coming. That's it, I'm just kind of pushing them and getting around. Maybe then I'll go to work. This is a really important part, okay? So I did my job to freeze him up and I just turn. A, I'm punching, now I'm squared up when I punch and I don't have any balance. Two, I'm lined up right in front of, I'm still kind of in front of them where I can be hit. So, freeze them up, step, scoot. Now, if he tries to pick up his foot moving, I kind of got his foot trapped. And I can still throw here. If he tries to turn again, boom, boom, I maybe have a different way to punch. So I got that dominant foot position with on the outside. Things to think about, doesn't matter which way I'm taking the angle. I don't wanna hop.
Okay. It's a little less shit than yesterday, so we're good.
I can shift and scoot while keeping my center gravity low by staying, keeping my legs loaded up, keeping my position. If I hop, it's like, here I come. And I don't wanna give my opponent that much of a warning. Again, like to show you how important that first step is in the position I'm going, if I throw that first one and I just turn, I'm in a shitty position, right? Okay. That's why I gotta...
Now you're in a less shitty position.
Less shitty position. When I say go, take an angle. Don't try not to do the same one over and over again. Just think how dizzy your opponent is gonna be. And two good guys to look at who can think off the the top of my head is Purnell and maybe Lomachenko. Lomachenko does his angles off of his footwork and off of the punches he throws, where Purnell might do his footwork off his head movement and off of the punches you throw. They're both southpaws. I'm sure I can think of some other people that are really good in angles, but those are two good people to watch. Good work. You gotta run.
Coach, yeah. That was great.
Good, that was good.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. I'm gonna finish off in double end bag. I'm gonna pump out three straight. So starting from now, three straight. So about, what's that, 10 minutes. Working what Chris was just putting us through. So that was angles on the heavy bag. Now I'll let my hands go a little more. You know, still trying to work those angles now on the double end bag. Not trying to put as much in every shot now. You want to be in a position where you can hit and not get hit. It's the aim of the game. Angles is how you do it. After you punch, don't be there to get punched back. Simple, not easy.